I didn't see clearly until I heard it from him. I didn't hear properly until I heard it from him. Blind because we couldn't see the word of God. Deaf because we didn't understand the word of God. And we were dead because we were inactive until he activated us. So that's the work of Jesus. Sit down, please. Get comfortable. So when we're able to look at one or look at the prophets of the past and see a specific work out of a Bible that we believe in, out of a Quran that we believe in, we can see the work of these prophets of the past, but then you can look at the same work being done by one amongst you, it only makes sense to be able to see the presence of God in that person that's standing right before you in your midst. And this is not to lower your prophet or attack your belief system to our guests who may be Christian or have a different religious orientation. But it's a truth that's being presented that if we are serious about God, about Allah, that we must look at. We can't make the Bible a history book where it's just some historical that we can look at. God hasn't changed. He doesn't change. So if he sent and raised messengers and prophets of that time, why wouldn't he do it in this time? He would do it, and he has done it. So it's a man in our midst who is doing and has done, without a doubt, the work of the prophet. Now make it clear, he never claimed to be a prophet. He has always come presenting himself as our brother. But today we can look at his effort, look at the minister's work, and see his work in his effort, in his offering, a work that lines up with the prophets and messengers of God of Allah. Say no, he's not a church pastor, bishop, who's not doing anything to transform life. Who's not speaking in a way to transform life. Yeah, you come to church on Sunday and he gives a word that hypes you up, but when you leave, you don't have any energy to utilize the word. Because it's a show. Jesus never had a choir walking behind him. Praise dancers all around him. These are men and women of show for people that are asleep. And since we're asleep, we need entertainment. But God isn't into your entertainment. He's into your transformation and our development towards him. Now, the Honorable Minister Lord Farrakhan began closing out last week's lecture with these words. He said, must Jesus be at the cross alone and all the world go free? There's a cross for you and there's a cross for me, he said. He said, somebody has to live it in front of you so that you know that it's real. But now, he said, it's on you. That's heavy.